Don't forget to subscribe and turn the notifications. We upload daily, and check the source of this video to view all the images and videos if there was any. As of this morning, liberals are still all at Twitter over Michael Cohen's guilt and his allegations against President Trump. It's the talk of the town among liberals, and I even had one call me last night to ask if it was true that Trump was going to be impeached. I said that will never happen, and to pass and evaluate the actual facts, don't listen to overblown leftist hyperbole. Cohen's accusations are full of holes, and it is basically his word against President Trump's, according to a number of legal analysts. What the left intentionally ignores at all costs are what Hillary Clinton and the Democrats are actually guilty of. But because they are so intent on removing Trump from office, the headlines are full of allegations and suppositions that are really nothing more than water cooler gossip concerning Trump. According to young conservatives, here are some of the inconsistencies the left is putting forth over the whole Cohen mess. 1. They're treating Cohen's allegations as an established fact that has some precedential weight. No, they're not. It's a plea deal, not an adjudication by a judge or a jury that what Cohen said was, in fact, the case. Trending, as Sarah exits briefing, hot mic catches devastating remark, she suffered too much, too. Cohen is copping to campaign finance violations because he faces a lot of time for tax issues. As Judge T.S. Ellis said in the Manafort case, that gives someone a powerful reason to embellish. 3. Cohen has a credibility problem because he said the exact opposite on prior occasions, that there was no campaign connection to the payments. 4. There's also been a question raised as to whether this is even a crime, as Mark Levin and former FEC chairman Bradley Smith have noted. In order for it to be a crime, you need to pay for it with campaign funds. It's perfectly legal otherwise. Or if you're going to make the argument that it was an in-kind contribution, you'd have to show that it was only for the purpose of the campaign, and not for any other reason, and if it happened, one could argue there were plenty of other reasons. 5. Not to mention that Cohen was politically targeted because he worked for Trump, and tarring him in some way was the goal. Let's not kid ourselves on that point. The investigation was supposed to be about Russia collusion, not about years-old tax or banking questions that had nothing to do with the campaign. Because there may have been a violation by Cohen doesn't change that fact. And that's a concerning fact. Because in America we're not supposed to be about prosecutions against political opponents. Yet this is exactly what the case against Cohen was. For almost 2 years, the left has been beating this Russia collusion thing to death with not a shred of evidence to prove any of it. And somehow they now think that a supposed campaign finance violation is their ticket to impeaching Trump. It's not going to happen. You can't impeach a sitting president on heresy. There's no evidence of criminality here that even comes close to touching Trump. I think the left knows that, and they are simply doing this to obstruct Trump's efforts to get things done and to impugn his presidency. Does anyone remember the no-knock warrant over Hillary Clinton and the DNC's payment for the opposition research dossier? That might bear examination, even though it has been proven that the dossier is pretty much a mixture of a few facts and a whole lot of lies. Clinton and the DNC who paid for the dossier have faced no repercussions for it that I know of. Mark Penn at The Hill wrote on the attempt to set Trump up. Contrast what is going on here with the treatment of the millions of dollars paid to a Democratic law firm which, in turn, paid out money to political research firm Fusion GPS and British spy Christopher Steele without listing them on any campaign expenditure form, despite crystal clear laws and regulations that the ultimate beneficiaries of the funds must be listed. This rule was even tightened recently. There is no question that hiring spies to do opposition research in Russia is a campaign expenditure, yet no prosecutorial raids have been sprung on the law firm of Fusion GPS or Steele. The reason? It does not get Trump. So, Trump spends $130,000 to keep the lid on a personal story, and the full weight of state prosecutors comes down on his lawyer, tossing attorney-client privilege to the wind. Democrats spend potentially millions on secret opposition research and no serious criminal investigation occurs. Remember that the Fed tried a similar strategy against Democratic candidate Edwards 6 years ago and it failed. As Gregory Craig, a lawyer who worked both for President Clinton and Edwards, said, the government theory is wrong on the facts and wrong on the law. It is novel and untested. There is no civil or criminal precedent for such a prosecution, tried it there anyway and it failed. Then there is the inconvenient little fact that if Mueller were truly looking for Russian collusion, he would be looking at the Democrats right about now, as well as Hillary Clinton and Barack Obama. That will never happen, and therefore you know that this was a witch hunt from the very beginning. And what about the investigation into the $84 million money laundering scheme allegedly conducted by Hillary Clinton and the DNC? Read this concerning allegation filed with the FEC. As Fox News reported, we documented the Democratic establishment, us, state chapters as straw men to circumvent campaign donation limits and launder the money back to her campaign. The 101-page complaint focused on the Hillary Victory Fund, HVF, the $500 million joint fundraising committee between the Clinton campaign, DNC, and dozens of state parties, which did exactly that the Supreme Court declared would still be illegal. HVF solicited six-figure donations from major donors, including Calvin Klein and Family Guy creator Seth MacFarlane, and routed them through state parties en route to the Clinton campaign. Roughly $84 million may have been laundered in what might be the single largest campaign finance scandal in U.S. history, crickets. It was basically ignored. Remember Donna Brazile's book? It backed it up and stated that some of that occurred before Hillary even won the nomination. In her 2017 book, Hacks, Brazile recounts how she saw the money being moved. Individuals who had maxed out their $2,700 contribution limit to the campaign could write an additional check for $353,400 to the Hillary Victory Fund. That figure represented $10,000 to each of the 32 states' parties who were part of the Victory Fund agreement, $320,000, and $33,400 to the DNC, reads a passage from the book. The money would be deposited in the states first, and transferred to the DNC shortly after that. Money in the battleground states usually stayed in that state, but all the other states funneled that money directly to the DNC, which quickly transferred the money to Clinton campaign headquarters in Brooklyn. We are still waiting on Hillary Clinton to be charged over this or anything for that matter. But onward with Mueller's investigation that in my opinion is a massive farce and a travesty of justice.